Harry is miserable in California, but tough William taught him. What a life lesson this is. Hello and welcome to the Royal Family News YouTube channel. There have been several stories recently that Harry is asking to rent an apartment at Kensington Palace, and has apparently even gone so far as to offer to pay for the furniture himself. He would have received a very quick no. And I guess William doesn't want Harry to be with his family for a multitude of reasons. The biggest was all the death threats from those Sussex Sugars against the whole Wells family. What the hell are they thinking? I mean, now that they want to rent an apartment in Kensington Palace, they have nothing to pursue but their connection to the royal family, and that connection is getting incredibly weak. Now it's just as big. I want to be like Meghan. It's just a case of her putting herself on the line, and the fact that he's the king's son, if that's true considering he despises the business. I mean, I would think that if he needed a place to live in the UK, he would buy something in London away from his family, but I guess he is desperate for that address, as it gives him the connection to his family and also the possibility of making the mansion his residence in the United Kingdom. Also, okay. So let's say he calls William and Williams and he doesn't take his calls, just for the sake of arguing. Why would William want to return his calls anyway? After all the trash that Meghan and Harry threw up at the royal family. The Williams family, his lovely wife, his beautiful daughter and Harry abusing the memory of their late mother and all the epic lies. The two said William would never want to talk to her. I mean, without lawyers and consultants present at least, and after. Harry is also carefully stripped and searched. I mean, whatever Harry has to say after all, the damage he and Meghan have done is probably not what William wants. I'm sure it upsets William just thinking about it. And then of course, I'm sure William is heartbroken by what happened to his little brother. Once upon a time, they seemed so close, and look what happened to their relationship. Because of that trash. All calls and communications from Meghan and Harry must go through the royal attorneys. The royal family know very well that Harry cannot be trusted. And of course Meghan can't, and you know they were going to tape calls to the royals for material. It looks like Meghan and Harry are completely ignored, and that's how it should be. The thing is, if Harry had never met me, then he would have had a pretty big role in the royal family for a long time, because he's the king's son, and later he would be the king's brother. He must know it, and he must know what he gave up listening to this demon. He chose to get married, and now look at him. So Harry is an ego. We saw that in Oprah's interview. You can see all of her videos about the idea. Let's forget about her own misinformation. I guess Harry let the media say the royals were racist for 2 years before trying to take it back. Harry also talked about his family. He needed to take responsibility and apologize for something they had done. Harry despises his brother so much that he has talked about his baldness and some personal private secrets for public consumption. I mean, he mentioned his brother's penis. How did he think everything was fine, and that he hates his father so much that he claims to have ordered fighter jets to pretend to bomb his father's vehicle, destroying personal property on someone's property anyone else? What a despicable person. And apparently he now hates Catherine so much that he tried to paint her as a cold, cruel escort bully. But he did not succeed. This just confirmed what we already knew, which is that Meghan is the bully in this situation. He has so little respect for his niece and nephews that he thinks it's okay for him to say what he wants about them. But if ever someone likes them, oh boy, are they going to get it from Harry. He hated his great-aunt Margaret, because she should sympathize with him, because she was also the reserve, and he also hates his aunt Anne, because she is hailed as the hardest-working royal. But these events, he said, were sometimes just small signs of error. He also despises his stepmother Camilla. In a normal company we talk about people moving up the corporate ladder, but in the real family things work, it's the opposite. You end up going down the ladder a bit with each baby born in the air. Well, Harry, that arrogant pedant can't take any of this. He won't come back, and he won't. I don't think he's calling his brother. I mean, after all, he hates William and is incredibly jealous of him. And don't get me wrong, I know Harry is absolutely miserable in California. He can't be happy, but he doesn't want to be happy because he has so many problems. But he doesn't want to go back to the country he hates, and he doesn't want to be with Will's kids, because they remind him of everything he'll ever be and everything he's lost. It tells us a lot to look at photos of Harry before the whole disaster of Meghan laughing and smiling around William and Catherine. We can compare these photos to later photos of him being dragged by this mean woman. Meghan Markle. He looks as miserable as can be in most of these photos. I think if Harry hadn't met Meghan Markle, he would have been a great support system for William. She married someone who wanted everything and realized the only way to get it was to fight for it. Well, look where he got them both. I don't think Harry ever really wanted to stop being a royal before Meghan came into his life, but I think he's easily manipulated and not very smart. So he accepted her small projects. Now, this has all been coordinated by Meghan Markle. It wasn't coordinated by Harry, and I guess at first Harry thought, oh, this is so exciting, but then reality hit. But at that seemingly deep moment, just as he was about to blow up his dad's car, it was a practice drill, and he talked about it and how he thought it was so funny to see his father driving down the road in one of his vehicles. And things apparently went from there, and Harry expressed no remorse or shame about it. There is something wrong with him. I mean, he told that story in that stupid backup book like it didn't matter. He also told the story of stealing makeup and laughing gas and stash that way. It was a pretty cute story. He's mentally disturbed, and I'm not putting anything beyond that at this point. King Charles and the rest of the family should really be worried about Harry's mental state in the story. There are stories of royals being murdered so someone else can get the throne. And let's remember the problem with Harry and a King Charles plane and vehicle. These were really scary things. The truth is, he never adjusted very well to his family's scrutiny of drugs, alcohol, and street fighting. Harry himself is racist. He was incredibly cruel to animals and women, and the list goes on and on. I think he's just not a very nice person. His behavior while in the force in which he was taken out of harm's way, because he was always surrounded and protected, his disparagement of real soldiers, and his racial slurs he made towards them. Funny, he was only funny for himself. Harry has only ever loved one person in his life, and that's himself. He lived off the story of his mother's actions and had a good time. When he died, he met the woman of his dreams and tried to harm the royal family with his nasty accusations. He was loved by Brits and many countries, but now I don't believe, because he connected with this evil demon who would sell his soul for a penny. And in the end, I hope he will be held accountable for his behavior. Maybe I should stop waiting or expecting Harry, because there is something deeply sick inside of him. Harry will never be happy, so he might as well stay in Montecito even after the divorce, because at least then he will have easy access to all those drugs he loves so much. So you know what, Harry, maybe you can just stay away from the UK and do everyone a favor. You'd probably be even more miserable there. After all, you should bow to people. You're so incredibly jealous and you clearly hate it. Who knows what might be thrown at you when you go out in public. Harry has serious emotional issues and may also have serious psychological issues. It is not easy for people with this kind of problem to feel happiness, because according to them everything revolves around them when they are at their best. Well, that's because they're great people, and when they get into trouble, well, it's somebody else's fault. Harry will never understand his part in his downfall. Their lives are truly roller coasters of doom, and we already have completed today. What do you think? Please tell me your opinion below in the comment section, and we can talk about this hypocrite too. Don't be afraid to like and share my video to anyone who needs it whenever you wish. Royal Family News YouTube channel to receive further updates in the future. Thank you so much for watching. Bye, and we'll be back to see you in future videos.